So a refresher, what is BST? What is behavioral skills training? This is from Pearson, Rollison, and Reed, 2012. First, describe the target skill. Provide the written description of the target skill to the learner. Demonstrate the target skill. Practice the target skill, or have the learner practice the target skill. Provide feedback on that practice, and then repeat the practice and feedback, possibly demonstration, practice, and feedback until the learner can master that target skill. Okay, so we want to incorporate the BST steps, and sometimes you'll see them shortened down. This is the one that I'm citing, but sometimes you'll see it maybe three or four steps instead. But we want to use these skills. We want to use BST to teach the skills that we are teaching our trainees. So what does that look like? First of all, we want to describe the target skill. This is where we're going to use the fifth edition task list, and we're going to create some operational definitions of the performance as it fits within the supervision setting. So like I said, token economy, great. If I'm an in-home setting, then here's how that would look. If I'm at a school setting, then here's what that is going to look like so that we can check that box from the fifth edition task list. We want to provide that written description of the target skill. So for global things, that's where we're outlining it in that contract, right? Globally, I want you to demonstrate all the skills on the fifth edition task list. These might also then be described in the treatment plans or the behavior intervention plans. So if I want someone to be able to implement a token system, I might provide the written description of that. And then that is what they're following to practice the implementation part. Or you could list these things out in a performance checklist of sorts. So if I'm going to come in and I'm going to watch you and I want to see you use prompting and fading strategies, then I'm going to define prompting and fading. I'm going to have them on the checklist for when I do my observation. So here's an activity. Now, this is recorded. So obviously, I have no idea if you're going to do the activity or not. But if you'd like to, pause for a minute and work on this little activity. So select a target skill. You can use the task list as a guide, or you could create your own particular skill based upon your setting. You want to write an operational definition for that that's going to identify the materials and the setting where and with what your trainee is going to perform this skill. And I always teach trainees our operational definitions include the stop and the start of the behavior, the verb, where, when, and with whom the behavior occurs. So for example, I could write when running a program from the treatment plan, the provider or trainee will deliver descriptive praise and a token or the learner's chosen item, depending upon the reinforcement schedule, within 2 seconds of a correct or appropriate response by the learner. Now I have a very specific example of what I want my trainee to be able to demonstrate. And now I can use this to then see if they can do it, right? We're writing our operational definitions for our trainees, just like we would for our learners. Then we can measure behavior change. So if you want to, pause, take a minute and practice doing this for a target skill or a possible couple of target skills. All right, so continuing with BST within training, demonstrate that target skill. So this is where we need to, as supervisors, be able to do what we are expecting of our trainees. So you might be able to model it within the supervision sessions. For example, if we were working on one of the skills about being able to describe or talk about a particular definition, you might be able to just model that in your session. If you were doing something like a preference assessment, I might be able to sort of model it here on the screen and act it out. You might not always be able to do those things within supervision sessions. So maybe you're able to model it directly with the client, whether you are in person or you're able to make a video model or find a video model from other resources that demonstrates this target skill that you are trying to teach. So there are a lot of ways that you can demonstrate it. It doesn't have to be your shoulder to shoulder with your trainee working with the same learner. There are lots of ways, and remote really requires a lot of not being shoulder to shoulder, where you are finding additional resources or creating resources for your trainees. Then we want to make sure that we are practicing, allowing that practice for the target skill. So you might be able to identify some activities within your current cases. So you have a learner that would be great to use a token system, or you have a learner that already has a token system. And in that case, maybe you could use those as practice opportunities where the situation already exists. Alternately, for practice, you could role play the skills. So we could role play, and I do this all the time with, I'm looking for something to hold, with like preference assessments. So I can hold them up and I can hand it to you, and then I can mock hand it back, and we can go through the motions, even though you can't physically hold the item that I'm doing the preference assessment for, we could still role play that on a computer screen.